multi-drug resistant Shigella species. Shigellosis is a serious public health problem. More than millions of people die in each year throughout the third world countries. Humans are the only reservoir, and transmission is caused by the fecal-oral route. The disease Shigellosis is caused by the bacteria Shigella species. That means Shigella flexneri, Shigella dysentery, Shigella sawney, Shigella boidi. It has enterotoxic, neurotoxic, and cytotoxic effect. Before, the antibiotics ampicillin, chloramphenicol, cotrimoxazole, etc., these drugs were used, but these are now useless. Nowadays, ciprofloxacin, azithromycin, ceftriaxone, these drugs are used. But day by day, the bacteria is also becoming resistant against these drugs also. So, in this situation, we have to find out an alternative. Phage therapy can be a good substitute for this. Now, what is phage therapy? Phage therapy is the therapeutic use of lytic bacteriophages to treat pathogenic bacterial infections. In history, there are several instances of using phage therapy. First, Ernest Hanbury Hankin and British microbiologist Felix Stott discovered bacteriophages. Then bacteriophages were used during Second World War in Soviet Russia for the treatment of gangrene and wound infections. Then bacteriophages were used for staphylococcal and streptococcal infections and so on. Now, what are the advantages of phage therapy? Phages are extreme specific and chemically large in nature. They do not cause allergies or affect the body's natural immune system. They have low chemotherapeutic index and they are green natural alternative, and its production is environment friendly. There are several companies which are now producing phage cocktail for the treatment of multi-drug resistant bacterial infections. They are Eliava Phage Therapy Center, SCD Pharma, Intralytics, Phagelux, Gangajan, etc. They are producing phages like mycobacteriophage for the treatment of MDR-TB, cholera phage for the treatment of cholera, staphylococcal phage for MRSA staphylococcus infection, pseudomonas phage for wound infection, E. coli phage for bloody diarrhea, etc. Recently, Hatful et al. Reported the use of phage cocktail for the treatment of cystic fibrosis infected with multidrug resistant Mycobacterium abscessus. Till now, around 45 Shigella phages have been discovered. Among them, some are temperate phages like SF6, SF101, etc. And some are lytic Shigella phages like SF9, SHFL1, etc. But there was no report of Shigella phages from India. In our lab, we are involved into the isolation of Shigella phages from environmental water samples. We have isolated Shigella phages from the river Ganga, the main river of our country, and these phages can show specificity against different Shigella species. Till now, we have isolated 8 Shigella phages. That is SFIN1, SFIN2 to SFIN8. Now I would concentrate my talk on the Shigella phage SFIN1, on the detailed characterization of SFIN1. Last year, we have published our work on the characterization of SFIN1 on frontiers in microbiology. And this is the first report of lytic Shigella phage from India. This phage SFIN1 have host specificity against Shigella flexneri 2A, Shigella dysentery 1, Shigella sawney, and most interestingly, E. coli C also. So this phage has a broad host range. Then we checked the activity on the Shigella species isolated from patient samples, which can be sensitive or resistant against the phage SFIN1. And we found that most of the samples are sensitive against the phage SFIN1. And it is noticeable that these species are antibiotic, most of the antibiotic resistant. This is the electron micrographic view of the phage SFIN1. This phage has an isometric head and non-contractile tail. So this can be concluded that this phage belongs to the Sifoviridae family. Now come to the bacteriolytic activity or cell lysis property of the SFIN1 on its different host cells like Shigella flexneri, Shigella dysentery and Shigella sawney. For that, Shigella flexneri cells were grown in presence of several antibiotics with particular doses, and then SFIN1 phage was added at different MOI. And it was found that within 3.5 hours, almost all cells are killed by this phage activity. Same phenomena was observed in case of Shigella dysentery 1, but in case of Shigella sawney, the lytic property is more rapid. That means SFIN1 can lyse the Shigella sawney cells more rapidly than Shigella flexneri and Shigella dysentery. This is the one-step growth curve of Shigella flexneri, SFIN1 on Shigella flexneri, dysentery and sawney. In each case, it shows that the latent period are same. That is, it is around 5 to 10 minutes. But the bud size are different. That means, in case of Shigella flexneri and Shigella dysentery, the bud size is around 27 to 28 PFU per cell. But in case of S. sawney, it is 146 PFU per cell. Now, what is the effect of temperature on the growth of SFIN1 in host cells? It was found that 100% activity was shown at 37 degrees centigrade and 50 degrees centigrade. Then activity slowly decreased from 60 degrees centigrade, but still some activity remains at 90 degrees centigrade. Now, what is the effect of pH on the growth of SFIN1 in host cells? It was found that 100% recovery at pH 7, but still some activity remains at pH 5 and pH 12. That means all this result concludes that this phage, that is the phage SFIN1, is a thermostable and have a wide pH tolerance. Then we isolated the whole genome of the phage SFIN1 and it was analyzed by whole genome sequencing analysis by next generation sequencing method. It was found that from this data that its size is around 50 kb. It has around 45% GC content. It predicts 81 CDS and its genome sequence is submitted into the NCBI data bank under this accession number. Then module analysis was performed and it was found that several gene clusters are present on the genome's genome sequence, and it have either structural or functional genes. They include virion morphogenesis, DNA metabolism and replication, DNA packaging, cell lysis, and most interestingly, hypothetical protein. Bioinformatic analysis revealed that the 28% genes of the total genomes only encodes the structural and functional genes and rest are hypothetical proteins. That means there is no clue of functions of these hypothetical proteins. That is they are, until now, these genes have no functions indicated into the bioinformatic analysis. And this SFIN1 genome also shows that it has sequence around 91 to 92% sequence similarity with its closer counterpart SHFL1 phage and PSF2 phage. Though these three phages, that is SFIN1, PSF2 and SHFL1, these three phages are isolated from different geographical locations, still they have this so much closest relationship into their genome sequence. Though these three phages have close proximity, far genome has close proximity, still the differences lied in between because they have the genes, they have the positions of the genes are different, and the gene orientations that are also different. For those reasons, these three phages have some differences, though they have similarity above 90%. GCSQ analysis revealed that the putative replication origin site is around at 10 kb region, and its terminus location is around at 34 kb region. Then come to the phylogenetic analysis of the SFN1 phage. It was when we analyzed with large terminus subunit, we use the large terminus protein with for this phylogenetic analysis using the Mega7 software, and it helps to find out that this phage belongs to the T1 like phage family. That means this phage belongs to this T1 group of phage family. Then we were trying to solve the problem about the genomic end of the phage. According to the phylogenetic relationship, the phage belongs to the T1 group of phage. So it is predicted that this phage genome is possibly circularly permutated with direct terminal repeats. For a circularly permutated headful packaging phage chromosome, the site of initiation cleavage is not precise. So, alternative initiation cuts are spread over regions on concatemers. As a result, chromosome length of individual variants are imprecise. In that case, a blur background was observed both in case of fast-cooled and slow-cooled reactions. Then we were trying to find out the receptor molecules on the host cells. That means where the SFIN1 phage can bind on the host cell receptor. Either it is protein or carbohydrate. That means carbohydrate means obviously LPS. For that, we treated the cells either with proteinase K or para-iodate. We have seen that proteinase K treated treatment have no effect on phage adsorption, whereas para-iodate treatment stops absorption. That means it proves that LPS is the receptor of phage SFIN1. Then we infect the SFIN1 into the E. coli C cells, and we found that SFIN1 infected E. coli C can lyse the multidrug resistant Shigella species more rapidly than only SFIN1 phage. That means these SFIN1 infected E. coli C cells can have the activity, more activity than SFIN1 phage. And we have applied these SFIN1 infected E. coli C cells for patent. This is the whole genome map of phage SFIN2. This is 3, this is 4, this is 5. And this is 6. All these sequences have been submitted into the NCBI database, and under this accession number.